She was once Britain's most hated woman, but now Camilla, the Queen's consort, occupies the throne beside her husband, King Charles III. So how did she get there? Our royal correspondent, Gavin Grey, joins us now from London to explain. Gavin, it's nice to see you. Thanks for being with us. She was Camilla Shand originally. What kind of family did she come from? Were they aristocrats as well?
No, they weren't really aristocrats. Good morning to you both. But they were a well-to-do family. Her father was a very successful wine merchant. How appropriate. And came from East Sussex, that's south of London. But crucially, he was Deputy Lord Lieutenant of East Sussex. So Lord Lieutenant's basically stand in for the Queen when she can't make an event in that county. And there are lots of deputies, and he was just one of them that occasionally did that. So that's the kind of family she came from, but a beautiful old house, and as I said, a pretty wealthy family and a very, very happy childhood.
So how and when did she meet Charles, Gav? I mean, was it a romance from the start?
I think it probably was, yes. At Windsor Great Park at a polo match, that famous photo, there it is, with Camilla and Charles, 1972. What was the chat-up line? Well, it was reported to be this. My great-grandmother was the mistress of your great-great-grandfather. I think we have something in common. What a great first line. Well, I suspect that it was all the magic was done there and then, and they began to date soon afterwards.
So what went wrong then, Gav? Why didn't they stay together?
You know, Sarah, I've been looking into this, actually, because they didn't stay together officially because Prince Charles was in the Royal Navy and he was sent to sea. I'm not a conspiracy theorist, but I've done a little bit of work and I actually reckon this was deliberately engineered to try and separate them. Why? Well, because Camilla wasn't one of the big family names and aristocrat. Neither, incidentally, were they that happy about the age gap, because Prince Charles was 22, the world's most eligible bachelor. She was 24 and, as I said, not Lady so-and-so or anything like that. And in those days, that mattered. And that could be, perhaps, why he was sent off to sea in a deliberate attempt to break up the relationship.
Well, so tell us a little bit about Andrew Parker Bowles, who is the man she did marry.
Yes, extraordinary. A very sort of dashing army officer. A couple of things. His parents were very, very close friends of the Queen Mother, Queen Elizabeth, the Queen Mother. Also, he was a page boy at the coronation in 1952, the Queen's coronation, which is something that often goes unmissed. He played polo in Prince Charles's polo team. Ouch. But perhaps the thing that I didn't even realise until recently, he was also Princess Anne's boyfriend for a while. So he was mixing in those sorts of circles in the 70s.
All right, so on her divorce from Prince Charles, Diana, we remember she famously said that there were three people in her marriage. Had the relationship between Charles and Camilla been going on all that time?
We have never really been told too much detail about that period, but I think it's safe to assume, yes, it had. Do you know that Prince Charles used to phone her wherever he was in the world? They used to speak, I think, pretty much on a daily basis, if not even more than that. Indeed, do you know that Prince Charles even asked Camilla to find him a wife? I mean, it's quite extraordinary. They were always close. They were always burning that flame for one another. And yes, that famous three of us in this marriage quote was aimed very squarely at Camilla.
It took a long time, Gavin, but a lot of people say he still hasn't. But how did Charles manage to recover from the divorce and the scandal?
It took a while, obviously. I mean, for a while, Camilla was, you know, persona non grata. I mean, there was so much press interest about this. And, of course, there was that awful, awful Camilla-gate scandal in which Prince Charles was having a conversation with Camilla describing how he wanted to be intimate with her. That was secretly recorded and then sold to the tabloids. It was excruciatingly painful and almost embarrassing me for now to relate. But, you know, it's very, very rarely referred to now, particularly this week, of course.
Yeah, the tabloids were just so cruel to Camilla at the time, weren't they? And it's interesting, we just showed a whole lot of photos of Charles and Camilla much later in life laughing. They always seem to be laughing together and having fun. They, as sad as it kind of was with the way it ended with Diana, I think it took a long time for people to get over that. You can't help but be swayed by just how in love the two seem.
Yeah, very much. And that came from, you know, this, I think, desire to be with one another. She really calms him down. She's a very good influence on him. She loves the outdoors. He loves the outdoors. She's got her own interest in horses. He's got his own interests as well with books. They both enjoy a bit of literature, actually. And you're right, they're always laughing. And she's really grounded him. She's very earthy, very earthy. And somebody who's great fun to be with. So, you know, from those early days when she was described as the most hated woman in Britain, Princess Diana used to call her the Rottweiler. That was used in some headlines as well. And when she was single, she was labelled a hag and an old bag as well in some tabloids. Absolutely horrendous treatment. I mean, there were quotes that are far worse than that. And when you consider that Meghan complains about the press dealing with her, oh, Camilla had to endure much worse. And she said, you know, I only got through it because of my family and close friends.
Joan Rivers once said that Camilla had a wicked sense of humour as well. And we've heard that she's quite an earthy person. William and Harry, have they forgiven Camilla and have they accepted her as their stepmother now?
Sarah, I think William is on board with it. I think Harry isn't. And I fear that one of the big things to come out of his book, which we're now being told is still going to be published this year, wow, but others are saying no, it won't because of the Queen's death. But I think in that book, scores are going to be settled. And I don't think he's any fan of Camilla's. I don't think she's done anything in particular to merit that. I just think, you know, it's always difficult with a stepmom, isn't it, as well?
Yeah.
So I fear we're going to see some pretty unpleasant things said in the book. Maybe that won't happen. I sincerely hope not. But Camilla, I think, and William have certainly managed to rub along OK together and are certainly fine in each other's company.
All right, Gavin Grey there in London. Appreciate your time. We'll see you soon.
Cheers, guys.
Bye, thanks, mate. Gavin. Take care.